Wei Tan Si, Udlukut, bonjour, greetings. The impacts of climate change are being felt across Canada, and Indigenous and Northern communities are among the most impacted, with climate change taking place three times quicker than in the South. And this is no different in Tuktoyaktuk, Northwest Territories, where sea ice is melting at an alarming rate, resulting in an eroding shoreline. This is threatening homes and other vital infrastructure. Northerners are on the front lines of Canada's efforts to fight climate change, and the community of Tuktoyaktuk has been working to protect residents, the environment, and infrastructure from the impacts. And it is here where elders, young people, scientists, and others are coming together in monitoring and documenting changes to identify solutions. To support these efforts, I am announcing more than $5.5 million in funding for climate change adaptation and clean energy initiatives in the community of Tuktoyaktuk through Crown Indigenous Relations and Northern Affairs Canada's climate change programs. With $3.6 million specifically going towards the Hamlet and the government of the Northwest Territories in support of Tuktoyaktuk's coastal erosion mitigation efforts, including the relocation of residents to a safer and long-term living area and the final structural design of measures to protect the shoreline. Our government continues to be a strong supporter of these locally led efforts by supporting community resilience and leadership to face the dramatic changes of climate change. We will continue to be there as residents of Tuktoyaktuk to protect and preserve their community for future generations. Thank you. Merci. Miigwech.
Hi everyone, this is Michael McLeod, the Member of Parliament for the Northwest Territories. Great news for Tuktoyaktuk today with the announcement of more than $5.5 million for climate change, adaptation, and clean energy initiatives. With sea ice melting at an alarming rate and erosion of the shoreline, the community continues to work to protect residents and infrastructure. Elders, youth, and scientists will work on documenting these challenges to find solutions to address these impacts and increase community resiliency. Some of this funding will go towards the installation of 51 kilowatts of solar power for four Hamlet buildings. Congratulations to Tuk and their continued work to address and mitigate our climate challenges.
On behalf of the Hamlet of Tuktoyaktuk, we'd like to thank the Government of Canada and Minister Vandal for the continued support that we've received for the following projects. We'd like to start off with the relocation project, where we've moved three units from the shoreline on the Arctic Ocean to south of the community of Tuk. I'd also like to say thank you to Infrastructure Invest in Canada plan project and the climate change and preparedness in the North program for the completion of the final stages of the erosion mitigation design. Just like to say thank you once again, and we look forward to your continued support in the future. Thank you.
Honorable Daniel Vandal, Minister of Northern Affairs, on behalf of Tuktoyaktuk Community Corporation, we want to thank you for your contribution to two very important projects, the Climate Monitoring Project and Smart Ice. These two programs represent and involves a true partnership of traditional knowledge and academic knowledge. Both models of inclusion began from the roots of Inuit society, beginning in Northern Labrador, and here we are today. Thank you very much for your continued contribution, Kuya Naini.